Secondary ionization. Dawson's secondary ionization. Today we will discuss secondary ionization. Dawson's secondary ionization. So here, on the factor, alpha is called Dawson's primary ionization coefficients. Dawson's primary ionization coefficient with respect to alpha. So this is because of alpha is because of primary current. There is a primary electron. Because of a starting electron, because of this electron, primary electrons. The Dawson is taken as a one constant, proportional constant. The ionization constant is alpha. It's called a primary ionization coefficient alpha. Okay. Similarly, Dawson is taken another coefficient that is called gamma, that is called Dawson's secondary ionization coefficients, gamma. Okay. So primary ionization coefficient because of primary current. And primary electron, because of primary electron, Dawson is taken as a one coefficient that is called alpha, and secondary ionization coefficient that is called gamma is taken like that. So, secondary ionization coefficient gamma is because of secondary electrons. Okay, so secondary ionization coefficient gamma is because of secondary electrons. That secondary electrons are because of collision. Right, collision. That atom is collided with the cathode, then emit the electron. Okay, so that is called that proportional constant is called secondary ionization coefficient. That is called gamma. This is taken. First energy coefficient is called alpha, and the secondary energy coefficient is called gamma. So, so by taking secondary energy coefficient gamma, it explains the concept of ionization constant ionization coefficient. So here, so first we have to understand this concept. Primary ionization, secondary ionization coefficient. Have to understand this concept. So look at here, Dawson's secondary ionization coefficients. So Dawson took secondary ionization coefficient means first, so what will happen when you are giving the cause of or when our switch is open, that condition, what will happen first? Electron release from cathode plate, electron release. That electron is collided with atom, gas molecule in between, between these two planes we are using from gas that is called nitrogen, and SF6, whatever it may be, dielectric gas we are using in between this. So, the electron is collided with the atom and then releases two electrons and the atom will become ion. Okay? The atom will become ion. In between these two players, then the primary ionization, so primary these electrons are increasing, and also the positive ions also. In between these two. Okay. In between these two plates. That means in between gas, because the gas, dielectric material, gas type dielectric material, the electrons are increasing and also ions also increasing, positive ions, A plus. That means the A plus ion is is attracted by the cathode plate and is collided with the cathode plate. So, okay, there is a kinetic energy, then there is an attraction between positive ion and cathode plate. So, because of that kinetic energy is increasing between the ion and the cathode plate because of that collision, the one more electron is released. That electron is called a secondary electron. Okay, during the starting condition, one electron is released, that is called primary electron, that because the primary electron is that ionization, primary ionization. Okay, that primary ionization can be explained by taking the primary ionization coefficient, that is called alpha. Similarly, also here also, because of positive ion, one more electron is released. So when the positive ion is collided with the negative plate, at that condition, one more electron is released, that is called secondary electron. That secondary electron coefficient, secondary ionization coefficient is called gamma. like this. Gamma is called a Townsend's secondary annihilation coefficient and is a function of the gas pressure, P and E by P ratio. E is called, here E is called electric field and P is called pressure. Gamma is a Townsend's secondary annihilation coefficient is a function of pressure P and is E by P. Okay, E by P ratio. So this is the some one drawback of Townsend's theory. So why is taken like this? Don't know. Is why is not explained? Okay, why is taken E by P? Why and that is the secondary energy coefficient is a function of E by P. So why is taken the ratio of electric field and electric field to the pressure? So this is the limitations of the Townsend's theory. So I will explain later limitations of Townsend's theory. Some 4 to 5 limitations are there. He has taken as an assumption. This is another assumptions. Okay. So like that is taken as assumptions, and by taking that assumptions is explained the secondary annihilation coefficients. Okay. So that is called secondary annihilation coefficient. Here. So we are denoted as N naught is called during the starting condition the electron is released, that is called primary electron, because of primary electron, that primary electron, the number of primary electrons are considered as a N naught. Okay, you know well, I think N naught is we are taken from primary energy. So because of it, cathode starting condition, some electrons are released, that electrons are come N. And also because of positive ion, some electrons are released. Because of positive ion, the positive ion is collided with the neutral plate and release the electrons, okay, say like secondary electrons. That secondary electrons are considered as N plus, N suffix plus. Okay, N plus is the number of secondary electrons produced due to secondary process. Clear? N naught is because of primary, okay, primary ionization, and N plus is because of secondary ionization. I think you are understood. N naught is called primary ionization when once the switch is open, or once when you are giving the power supply to this two electrodes, in that condition electrons are released, that is called N naught. And because of collision between these two, atom, positive ion and cathode, there is a collision between these two, because of that one more electron will be released, that electron is called N plus. Number of secondary electrons are produced due to secondary process, that is called N plus. So like that is explained the secondary energy coefficient. So right here N naught, this is called N naught. Okay, let N naught be the number of electrons released from cathode by ultraviolet radiation or otherwise external supply. So ultraviolet radiation or external supply, during the starting condition some electrons are released, that is called N naught. Okay, this is N naught, not N. N naught be the number of electrons are released from the cathode by ultraviolet radiation. Okay, we are denoted like this. And then N plus is the number of electrons are released from cathode due to positive ion bombardment. So that is a collision between positive ion and cathode. Okay, because of that N plus answer is, we are denoted like this. All of you write this too. What is by N naught here? What is by N plus? Here N naught. Don't write N. So N naught is the number of electrons released from the cathode ultraviolet radiation. Okay, and N plus is the number of electrons released from the cathode and positive ion bombardment. So N is the number of electrons are reaching the anode. So total current is called ID. So ID is nothing but ND. So total number of electrons are ND. Then current is called, is proportional to the number of electrons, that is called based on the electrons. So ND is called total number of electrons, that ID is called total number, current across the anode. Okay. So let gamma is known as the Townsend secondary energy coefficient, is defined as the number of electrons released from cathode, incidence positive ion. You know well, so how we are getting the secondary electrons. Okay. So the secondary electrons because of primary electrons, we have taken as a primary ionization coefficient, that is called alpha. Because of secondary electrons, that is called positive ion is collided with, there is a bombardment between the positive ion and this cathode. Because of that, there is a collision occur. Because of that, electrons release, that is called ionization coefficient is called gamma. So yesterday, we are already discussing primary ionization coefficient, Nd is equal to Nr into e power alpha is, right? Nd is equal to Nr into e power alpha. Then total number of electrons are, total number of electrons are nothing but N0 plus N plus 1. N0 because of, during the starting condition, when the power supply is zero, at that condition, N0 are released. Okay. So that is called N0. Total at cathode place, the electrons are released from N0. And because of positive ionization, because of secondary ionization, some one more electron released. Remaining electrons consider as a N plus. Because of secondary ionization, N plus number of electrons are nothing but N plus. Because of primary ionization, the number of electrons are released, that is called N naught. Then Nd is equal to N naught plus N suffix plus equal to Rx. Okay, like that. Now the total number of electrons are released from the cathode is N naught plus N plus. So not N, N naught. Right here, N naught plus N plus. Now, total number of electrons are released from cathode is N0 plus N plus Nd. Those reaching the anode are Nd. That means that total electrons are nothing but Nd. So, from cathode to anode, the electrons are reached. How many number of electrons are reached? For example, here some 3 electrons are released because of collision. So, one more electron, number of 6 electrons, 12 like that. So, how many electrons are increasing? That electrons are reached to the anode plate, that electrons are gone, ending. Okay. Now, total number of electrons are released from the cathode is called N0 plus N plus, not N, N0. So, during the starting condition, N0. Because of ionization, N plus. The total number of electrons in between these two is across the gas. The number of electrons are nothing but N0 plus N plus. And those reaching the anode are ending. Okay. The total number of electrons are reached to the anode is called Nd. Okay, the number of electrons are released in the gas is nothing but, so when you are subtracting the total number of electrons, how many electrons are released from the Nd, then subtracting the total number of Nd minus N0 plus N plus, and you are subtracting this N0 plus N plus electrons from here, so Nd minus N plus N0 plus N plus. The number of electrons are released from the gas is equal to Nd minus N0 plus N suffix plus. All of you write like this. So Nd minus N0 plus N plus. So stick, putting this up here. N0 plus N plus here. Nd minus N0 plus N plus. Okay. So all of you write like that. Don't write N minus N plus N suffix plus. Nd. Total number of electrons are reached to the anode place is called Nd, and then when you are subtracting the these electrons are Nr plus N plus, you will get the number of electrons are released in gas. Okay. Then Nd is equal to Nr into e power alpha t, you know that primary ionization coefficient. This is the nonsense current growth equation, so we are getting the equation. Nd is equal to Nr into e power alpha t. The equation changes to Nd is equal to Nr plus N suffix plus into e power alpha t. N naught plus N suffix plus e power alpha. Not red lines. Don't write here N only. N naught. N naught plus N plus e power alpha. Nd is equal to N naught into e power alpha. It is okay. So Nd is equal to N naught plus N plus into e power alpha. So here N naught plus N plus are the electrons are cathode. N naught plus N plus are the electrons are cathode. So at cathode plate here, at cathode place, during starting condition, N0 electrons are released. At cathode plate only, because of collision of positive ion, the N plus ions are released. Okay, that is called total number of electrons are released from cathode is nothing but N0 plus N plus. It's clear, all of you? So, yeah, the number of electrons are released, we are finding the how many number of electrons are released from the gas. How to find the number of electrons are released from the gas? So, by taking total number of electrons, here and subtracting the number of electrons generated from the cathode plates, then you will get number of electrons are generated from the gas. I'll be clear, this is concept is important. First, during the starting condition, N0 electrons are released. Okay, I'll be listening again. During the starting condition, N0 electrons are released. And because of positive ion, and collide with this cathode plate, and one more electrons are released. Because of positive ions, there are one more electrons released at cathode plate only. So that the total electrons at cathode plate is nothing but N0 plus N plus. It's clear? Then subtracting from total electrons, ND, then we will get the how many electrons are released from the gas. The gas may be dielectric. Clear? So N0 plus N plus are the number of electrons are at cathode only. Previous primary ionization coefficient that only N0 electrons are released, only N0. But during the secondary ionization coefficient, so because of collision of between positive ion and cathode, because of collision between the positive ion, in between positive ion and cathode, another electrons are released, that is called secondary electrons. The total electrons are nothing but N0 plus N plus. So N plus is the additional electron. So actually N plus is proportional to additional electrons. N plus is proportional to additional electrons. It's clear. N plus is proportional to additional electrons. So if you want to remove the that proportional constant, we are introducing that is called Townsend's is introducing one more coefficient that is called gamma. So N plus is equal to gamma into additional electron. Same as Ohm's law, E is equal to I into R. E is proportional to I into R. Then E is introduced in one element that is called resistor, E is equal to R. Same as here also, N plus is proportional to the additional electrons. The additional electrons because of positive ion impact on cathode. There is a collision between the positive ion and cathode because of that number of some electrons are really additional electrons are released. That additional electrons are nothing but N plus. N plus is proportional to the additional electron, then N plus is equal to, you want to remove the proportionality, so what you have to do, we have to introduce one constant that is called N plus is equal to gamma into additional electron. So like that, additional electrons are nothing but additional electrons are, so because of gas, no, from gas we are getting additional electrons, we are getting additional electrons when we are subtracting from total electrons, how many electrons are reached from anode, that electrons are called ND, and N0 plus N plus, the electrons are released from cathode. When you are subtracting ND minus N plus, N0 plus N plus, that is called additional electron. ND minus N0 plus N plus is called into gamma. It's called additional electron. It's clear. This is called up to here. This is primary ionization. Because of primary and secondary ionization, so this. So we are introducing one coefficient that is called gamma. So like this. So here is enough, and one more. I will tell you one problem about primary ionization coefficients. Remaining derivation I will explain in later class. So try to write this is one problem based on a primary ionization coefficient. After that, I will close the session. All of you write this problem. I think all of you completed up to here. N plus is equal to ND minus N0 plus, here N0 plus N plus into gamma. So remaining concept we will discuss next class. All of you, so this problem, a steady current of 600 microamps flows through the plane electrode separated by a distance of 0.5 centimeters. A steady current of 600 microamps flows through the plane electrode separated by a distance of 0.5 centimeter when a voltage of 10 kV is applied. Determine the Townsend's first ionization coefficient if current 60 microamps flows when the distance separation is reduced to 0.1 centimeter. The field is kept constant at previous value. The field is kept constant means 10 kV is constant here also. Then the separation is reduced between the two plates 0.1, 0.5 to 0.1 we are reducing. At that condition also 10 kV. All of you completed. Steady current of 600 microamps flows through this plate electrode separated by a distance of 0.5 centimeters. When a voltage of 10 kV is applied, determine the Townsend first energy coefficient, that is called alpha. Determine the Townsend first energy coefficient, that is called alpha. If a current of 60 microamps flows when the distance of separation is reduced to 0.1 centimeter and the field is kept constant. Here we know first consider this is called I1. I1 is equal to 600 microamps. I1 is called D1. ID is equal to I0 into e power alpha D. That is called primary ID is constant primary current growth equation. ID is equal to I0 into e power alpha D. Am I right? ID is equal to I0 into e power alpha. By using that formula, we are finding alpha. Okay. So I1 is equal to 600 microamps and D1 is called 0.5 centimeters. And the field is constant, that is called E, electric field in between two plates, E is constant, 10 kV. And so you are asking the determine the Townsend's first energy coefficient, that is called alpha. And by taking current is reduced to 60 microamps, 600 to 60 microamps, and the distance also reduces 0.5 to 0.1. So that means D, I1 is equal to 600 microamps, D1 is equal to 0.5 centimeters, and I2 is equal to 60 microamps, and D2 is equal to 0.1 centimeters, like that. So ID is equal to I0 into e power alpha d1. I1 by I2 is equal to e power alpha d1 by e power alpha d2. Like that we are getting the equation. It's clear by doing so like that. ID is equal to I0 into e power alpha x. First 600 is equal to I0 into 600 microamps. First 600 is equal to 600 is equal to I is equal to I0 into e power alpha. D is called distance. Here x is equal. So notation is same, different. 600 microamps is equal to I0 into e power 0.5 into alpha. 60 microamps is equal to I0 into e power 0.5. I1 is called 0.5. D1 is called 0.5 centimeters. I1 is called 600 microamps. So I2 is equal to 60 microamps and D2 is equal to 0.5. So then we will get I0 is equal to e power 0.4 into 1. So divide these two, you will get easily 600 by 60 is equal to so I0 cancel e power 0.5 alpha e power 0.1 alpha. So divide these two, so I0 cancel 600 by 60 is equal to I0 by I0 into e power 0.5 alpha by e power 0.1 alpha. Speak like that. So you will get alpha 5.75. All of it clear? I is equal to I0 into e power alpha, so you know well, and I1 is equal to 600 microamps and is equal to I0 into e power 0.5 alpha. And I1 is called I1 and this is called D1. And then I2 is equal to 60 and D2 is equal to 0.5. When dividing these two, 600 by 60 is equal to I0 into e power 0.5 alpha by I0 into e power 0.1 alpha. So this will be better. That is called primary ionization coefficients. So like that we are finding. It's clear. So this is about today's session. So this the class we will continue the remaining sessions. It's clear. Any doubt about problem? All of you clear?